What's up, guys? It's Lester from Magic, and we are back with another episode of MLB 14. MLB 15, the show with our fantasy draft franchise mode with the Pirates. The last episode, oh my god, that was a train wreck of all pitchers to get. Shut up, don't talk over me. Shut up, don't talk over me. Shut up. God, this guy is fucking in it. But I don't care. Shut up. That's out of the way. Now, as I was saying, we're back with what was I saying? See what you make me do? You make me lose track of what I was saying. Prick. Now, last time we got stuck with a really shitty matchup, with the pitching having to pitch against Nolan Ryan, and as I do remember, let me look at this calendar here. We lost. What was it? We lost that game 4-0, basically on the shoulders of Prince Fielder. So hopefully this game can be a little better. Doesn't seem like we're facing a Nolan Ryan-esque player at all. So let's get into it. Here we go. What are we having? Alright. Let's get it going.
Friday evening in Milwaukee means Fish Fry Friday in the parking lot and baseball at Miller Park in Milwaukee. Tonight, the opener of a three-game series between the Pirates and the Milwaukee Brewers.
Hopefully our bats aren't completely transparent and invisible this game.
Hi again, everybody. Matt Vasker.
Seemed like they were last game,
so. Central Division matchup. Alongside me are Eric Karros and Steve Lyons. And Steve, a good matchup on the mound here in this opener.
Well, here's a couple of guys that are making their season debut. Now, they've just been watching these first few games, so you know they're itching to finally get out there and pitch. So we'll see what they've learned, and we'll also see which guy gets off to a good start.
I'm going to say, so we're not really...
We'll hear more from the guys as the night moves along, but first, let's get a look at the starting lineup for the visiting Pittsburgh Pirates, as manager Clint Hurdle has his squad lined up like this.
Alright, let's see if we can actually hit the ball this game.
And there you see the starting pitcher they'll match up against as you look at his numbers on the right side of your screen. Kenny Lofton will get his first opportunity now.
Alright, now maybe we can hit the ball.
Yeah. Here comes a 1-2. Pitch in the dirt is swung on and
missed. I don't think we're going to hit balls that are there.
So first is in time to get him. So that'll go down as a strikeout and a 2-3 put out for out number one. Derek Fink will get his first shot now. He too had three knocks in yesterday's win. Now here's a ball.
Oh. Really? Is this how this is going to go already?
Ralph Kiner will step in for the first time. And as you can see, not the fastest of starts for him this first week of the season.
Come on.
A ball and two strikes. The count now with the base take a look at the Brewers entering play here tonight. It's official now. They will not go 162-0. They were handed their first loss of the season last time
out. I think we all know. Adrian Mantz pitching, so.
Take his first cuts of the ball game here. Now the 1-2. And a good take there. Close, but it's 2-2. EK, you take a look at our visitors as they enter play here this evening. They come in off to a bit of a slow start, but just one win in their first three tries.
Yeah, if you look back to that last game, you'll take production like that anytime you can get it. It makes a starter's life easier. Heck, it makes your whole staff really easier.
And this will be taken in by Longoria for the first down.
It's an easier.
Echeverria digs in at the plate. Ready now on 1-1. And that misses 2-1. Now here it comes. To 2-2 now.
And that's about where he'll sit with that fastball. 93, 94. And that's plenty hard enough to blow by guys if you need to.
Now a swing, and he pops him up. Burnett, take charge himself out there, and there's two down.
Good.
We'll get his first cut now, right. And he'll do so with the bases empty.
Seems he's pitching pretty nice so far, so that's a good thing. If we don't get behind right away, like we did last time, we should be just fine. Because I think that was kind of what happened. Like, I got behind, and then I just couldn't get back there. If you're talking about, like, what shadow are you talking about?
Evan Longoria leads things off now in the top half of the second. The 1-1.
Boy, oh my God.
As bad as you can fool a guy, it's 1-2.
And that slider's going to make some guys look bad. When he's throwing it good, it's a
that
really
was so bad. That was, oh my God.
And this is
boom. There you go.
First hit of the ball game.
Well, even when you keep him in the ballpark, he can be trouble. Here he's right on this pitch, and he smokes it into left field for a solid single.
No, that is not on TV. That is that's just in the game.
Bryce Harper will stand in now. He homered in the ball game yesterday afternoon.
That's just to show me where to go to catch the ball.
1-1 on the way. A big uppercut there as he pops.
See, like, now it isn't there.
Under it is Machado, and he'll take it for the first down. Mike Napoli will take his first cuts here with the runner still at first and one away.
It's a good question, but
here's the 1-1. And he turns this one around kind of, high and deep to center field.
Come on, don't you dare catch that. Aw. Pooh.
Carlos Ruiz will get his first chance at it now. He didn't factor much into the win yesterday as he took an 0-for-4 in the ballgame. 3-2, here it is. A ball hit hard to the left side. And that'll get down for a base hit.
Yeah, that would be really weird.
So even on the hit and run, they'll hold things to first and second here. Yunel Escobar will get a shot now with two on and two out here in inning number two. Here comes the 1-2. And a drive out to deep right center field.
Come on. Get out of here. Get out.
And good ball. Planted into the bullpen in right center.
There we go.
So a three-run shot to right center field, and the lead for the Pirates is now 3-0.
There you go, baby. There you go. How sweet is that?
You just can't throw that pitch right there. That swing tells a story right there. I mean, he got all of that one. Remember, he homered in yesterday's ball game too, so riding a pretty good hot streak these past couple of days.
That's nice.
Stepping in now, AJ Burnett. Adam off. One and two.
Hey, give him credit up there. He's gonna take his hacks.
Clear the deck. Cannonball coming.
And he strikes him out here, so he's able to stop the bleeding a bit as this side is retired. But the Pirates play inning all coming on this three-run home run. Onto the bottom of inning number two. It's now 3-0 Pittsburgh.
Don't bring those IC chips. Those IC chips taste like shit. I thought they were supposed to be barbecue flavor. They all taste like metal.
Pitch on its way. Swing and a miss on the fastball, and that's the first out.
Yeah, and on this pitch right here, you got to make up your mind just a little more quickly up there. This is a ball that you got to think about maybe taking the left field, but instead, his swing is just a little bit late. He pulls off a little bit, and now he's going to go sit down.
And oh, that looked like it caught him squarely in the arm. Well, this is certainly something you never want to see. Perhaps the silver lining here, if there is one, is that that got him in the non-throwing arm.
Uh-oh.
So if he had to work his way through this, he probably could, assuming, of course, that there's nothing broken in there. And I think he is indeed planning to give it another go. Salvador Perez will get his first shot here with the runner at first now and one away. 1-1 pitch on the way. Hit on the ground to shortstop. To Escobar for one.
Boom.
Napoli, it's a double play, and the inning is over. So no runs on one base hit, no errors, and no one left on. We play two.
Those are three weird ass photoshopped faces.
And the Brewers nothing.
Well, Connor's face is kind of funny.
Back to the top of the order now, and standing in is the veteran center fielder Kenny Lofton.
Come on, baby, come on. Give me something to hit. There you go.
And that's down, scored as a leadoff single for Lofton.
No.
Derek Fink will stand in now. He'll likely have a look down to third to see if anything's up here with nobody out. Here's the 1-1. No offer on that one. Two balls and a strike.
And I think that's been a big part of the problem so far. He just can't locate his fastball, especially in situations where he has to.
And he turns on this one and yanks it foul and back out of play.
This game already going considerably better than the last one.
2-2. Now a swing and a miss as he picks up another one.
Well, it helps when we're not facing Hall of Famers.
Ralph Kiner will dig in here. Took a called third strike his first time. Here's the 1-1 pitch. 1-1 pitch is a slider that's cut on and missed for strike two.
And this is a guy who will not get cheated up there. And he almost came out of his shoes on that one.
Runner back standing. Here's the 1-2. Now a ball rolled slowly down the third baseline.
Oh, that's a nice play. Man, I don't even... That was... I'm not even going to pitch about that one. Now. That was...
Singled and later scored his first time. Here's the full count offer. Now a hard liner towards...
Oh!
Won't get by the shortstop as he's there to take it to the third out. One left for Pittsburgh, but they're on top by a count of 3-0. Manny Machado makes his way to the plate to get us started here in the bottom of inning number 3. Swing and a miss on the fastball, and it's 1-2.
Yeah, kind of a late decision to swing there. Even if he hits that thing,
no,
that
was
a routine fly to right.
That was a really nice play.
Hard toward first. And that's a fair ball as this one will get down the line. David Peralta will get his first shot at it here. Here comes the 1-1. Good break on the knuckle, but he missed with it. 2
missing right here, he ain't missing by much. Not getting too many favors behind the plate.
Opposite field to left.
My God.
Oh, and he misses it.
Come on, you're a Hall of Famer. You can't be missing, though. Ooh. Come on, man.
Here's the 1-1 pitch. And no surprise to see the pitcher squaring around as he gets this one down. And you can't ask for much more out of a pitcher than that. The sacrifice works to perfection. Juan Ligares. Stand in now in a spot where just a well-placed single could make this a one-run ballgame.
Yeah, I'll do it.
And there's ball four now, so the bases are loaded here on the intentional walk, and the force at the plate is in order. The 1-1 home. And he lays off for a ball.
Oh,
now the pressure will really start to mount out there. That strike zone is going to feel like it's the size of a soup can right now.
2-1 pitch is a sinker swung on and missed. 2-2. Swing and a hard hit grounder down the line. But a foul ball as it holds it 2-2. 2-2 pitch on the way. Swing and a liner.
Jesus.
Foul. Sets the 2-2 pitch. And this is swung on.
Boom,
and missed.
Baby.
So a huge punch out there as the bases remain loaded with two away now. Brandon Belt to get a chance here in one of the bigger spots in the ballgame thus far. Bases loaded now with two away. Here he comes on 2-2. And he strikes him out. So a missed opportunity at the plate as he strands three runs.
Nice.
Back yes. Strikeouts keep him out of danger. We're back to Friday Night Baseball on the show after this. Bryce Harper will stand in now to get us going here in the fourth. Now the 1-1. This is sharply hit back up the middle, and the leadoff man is
going to
reach out. He's got a base hit.
Gee, don't throw it away.
Yeah, he hit a good pitch there. This thing's toward the outside part of the plate, but he stays with it all the way. Uses the big part of the field and gets himself a base hit.
Mike Napoli will dig in here. He flew out his first time around.
Oh, baby.
Now the 3-2 pitch. Swing and a ball
hit. Nope. That one's tailor made. Double play.
Go on to first. He'll get the slow footed Napoli a double play. Carlos Ruiz will stride in again. He singled and later scored his first time. Now the 1-1 pitch. 1-1 pitch is lifted in the air out to right.
That puts
and
into the game.
They're in plenty of time to put this one away, and that ends the inning. Nothing doing here for Pittsburgh. They lead it 3-0.
All right,
Brandon Moss will lead things off here in the home half of the fourth. And here's a fastball, not close, as he runs it to 2-1 now. And this is something we've seen a lot from him recently. He's worked his way into another good hitter's count.
Yeah, it's not unrelated either. When you're going good at the plate, usually means you're being selective and you're not getting yourself out.
Now look who's striking guys out.
Chase Utley will stand in, the National League starter at second base in last year's All-Star game. And the pitch misses low and away for ball two. Here it comes. And Utley not fighting
what?
That one. He's ahead in the count now, 3-1.
Oh, wow.
It's time to attack now because these guys haven't been in too many good hitters' counts. This is where you need to pounce.
And Utley's able to reach.
That was kind of ridiculous. I don't understand that one.
Again, over one in the ballgame. Pitch swung on and hit in the air toward the line and right. Harper is over.
There you go, Bryce. Good job.
For the second out of the inning. Manny Machado will dig in. He singled his first time around. And this will be fouled away. Here's another 0-2. Now a fastball.
Boom, baby.
Let that one fly in the inning.
Yes.
Is over.
Nice.
Yunel Escobar, will make his way towards the box to lead off the fifth. A couple of righties starting to loosen now in the bullpen. Here's the 3-2 pitch. Now a ball slapped hard the opposite way. And the leadoff man gone now to start.
Oh, man. So many very well hit balls.
Looked like for all the world it was a sure single leading off the inning. It certainly hit hard enough, but evidently it was hit a little too hard as it winds up getting flagged down. And that's just a tough break.
Into the box now, A.J. Burnett. And he pumps the fastball by him here, 1-2 now.
It's a pitcher who gives a shit.
A lot of guys late on the fastball tonight.
And he's not throwing all that hard either, but when he throws it off the other pitches...
Ah, well, pitcher getting a hit's always nice.
And the pitcher's got himself a base hit.
Boy, he's doing it all out there so far. Not only is he pitching a great game, but he gets in on the act offensively as well.
Kenny Lofton will stand in. A strikeout victim his first time and then a base hit last time around. Here's the payoff pitch. Swing, hard hit ball to second. And that's through for a base hit. And that runner will go to
third. Nope, you're good. Good. Still doing good.
Derek Fink will try it again. He's grounded out and struck out in two trips. Full count offering on its way. Swing and a ground ball towards the hole. And he whiffs on it as this ball's right under his glove. The throw to the plate. And on the error, a run is going to score.
Yes!
When you're already losing, the one thing you can't do...
Look at that, I got a trophy.
You're already in the hole. The last thing you want to
do... me? All it is... Like, most of it is skill by the player. Wow, that was close. But the only skill, as far as I'm concerned, is the only skill, as far as I'm concerned, is timing on the hits and what type of hit I use. Most of the time, almost all the time, I'll use a power hit, just because it's a good decision. Because otherwise you're just going to weakly hit it everywhere. So, sometimes when you're doing that, you'll hit it weakly. That 5-0 now. 5-0.
Well, that's a good job here to plate their second run of the inning. Just a simple ground ball was all he needed, and he got the job done, playing some good small ball.
Some action out in the bullpen, couple of right-handers starting to loosen up.
Yeah, that replay was nice.
Ready now on 1-1.
That replay really showed all there, too. That's the thing I love about it. Showed exactly where he slid his hand in right before.
1-2.
Oh, man. I'm a little anxious. I was a little anxious there.
So two runs on two hits.
That was my fault.
One error and home half of the fifth coming up. Pittsburgh leads this one 5-0. 3-2, here it comes. And that misses ball to lead off walk to get the home half of the fifth underway. Henry Prater will get the call here as he'll hit for the pitcher.
I guess they kind of need runs as soon as they can possibly get them, don't they?
No runs, two hits, one error thus far in the game for Milwaukee. Fouled straight back. Try again, 1-2.
As far as our other videos go, guys, Pokemon Soul Link. I have a lot of episodes of that backlog that I just need to put them up. So that's kind of my fault. I can't. And then Ash Gray, I gotta figure out what the hell's wrong with the all the setup stuff, because something's going screwy with that. I think it keeps switching the aspect ratio every time on me.
Stay with it here as he puts the squeeze on it for out number one. Juan Ligares will step in and we'll see if they decide to pitch to him this time around.
Yeah, I can't wait for most Soul Link either. Concerning were the two that I have to record it tomorrow. I still have all the episodes I think backlogged. I think I might have to re-download your part of the video, but some Yu-Gi-Oh stuff may be coming. I'm not sure. It all depends on, because I have a couple of videos recorded for that. It seems like there's some people that might want to see that stuff, so I might put that up. Again, like, if I wasn't so damn bit, come on, pick up the ball. Yep. Wow. Jesus.
Big pitch here, 1-2. And now a pitch hit sharply on the ground. Step on the back for one. On to Napoli, and they get two here to get him out of the inning. A golden opportunity to get on the board here goes for more in a moment on the show.
There we go. Probably didn't even see that slick move. Just freaking toe tap third and boom. On to first. That used to happen so damn quick. I almost didn't even see it. I was just praying to actually step on the base. And we still have Coliseum yet. I still have some videos of that that have to be edited and uploaded a little. Just basically rendered to upload. I have so many things that need to be done yet. Like, it's ridiculous. It really is.
Here's the 2-2 offering. Right on that pitch that time as you wraps it into center field, a base hit.
There we go. This is a lot better than last game, man, I tell you.
A couple of hard hit balls here to start the inning. The first one found a glove, but not this one, though. He's on with a one out single. Carlos Ruiz will dig in now. A single and a fly out for him in two trips thus far. Now the veteran deals on 1-2.
Again, like, I just have so many things backlogged. It is ridiculous. It's so nuts. Because, like, I just have no time to do anything. Oh, here, watch this. Watch.
He's gonna have to bear down now and make sure that this thing doesn't get any worse.
It's a replay of the home run from earlier.
Oh
my God. Get out of here.
And that one's out of here. Put another nickel in the merry-go-round. This one is getting ugly.
Oh my God.
So a three-run blast to deep center here. His second of the game as they've widened this lead to 8 now. Well, it seems to me like we've seen this before. His second home run of the ball game. And it would seem to me like that one harder than he did the last one. So he's definitely locked in.
Oh my God. feet. Holy shit.
In now, AJ Burnett.
That ball got fucking crushed. Oh my God. That's the best thing ever.
So two balls and two strikes now. Would you say he's not really finishing his pitches at this point?
That's a good way to put it. It looks like he's aiming a little too much and that's not working for him.
Oh my God, the pitcher's getting hits. It's a two-hit game for AJ Burnett, too. Holy crap. I don't know what to think about this. Your last team's a bitch, but this team's too easy. I don't know. We're in the same difficulty, too. What the hell do I do? You know? I'm hoping this is just a fluke, so... I mean, I hope I can win more games, but I hope it... Like, this type of game... Where I completely blow everybody else away is just a fluke. No, he's... He's not bad at bat, like, but no pitcher's supposed to be that good.
And a fastball swung on and missed as they set him down for the second time here tonight. Derek Fink will stand in, one of the few guys not to join the hit parade so far. Here's the 1-1. Now a hard hit ball back up the middle. A diving effort here as he gets the glove on it. And the recovery throw will be too late for the force at second, so that'll be scored an infield hit, and there are two on with two away now. Ralph Kiner will step in now.
But when you're hitting better than one of the best, better than one of the best hitters in baseball history, that's impressive. As a pitcher.
Three runs already home here.
Really? This crap? What did I even say? What did I even say to make that come up? What the hell did I say? What did I even say? Oh, really? Oh, my God. Wow.
Evan Longoria.
This is actually getting a tad ridiculous, but I'm going to keep going with it, I guess. If we can. Jesus!
And that's in there. Base hit.
Holy crap!
And being waved on hold. And on the error, a run is going to score.
You think he was looking for a fastball there? I think he was. That's about as hard a hit ball as you're going to see. And he was right on that one.
Hmm. Wow. All right then.
1-1 on the way.
Again, I do not know what to think of this.
Peralta,
you know?
There and he puts it away to stop the bleeding. But not before five crossed the plate, with the big blow being this three-run home run. Bottom of the sixth is straight ahead. It's the Bucks 10.
I think I know who's getting
the Brewers nothing.
Ooh, I actually don't know who's getting the player of the game now. Because if A.J. Burnett pitches the entire game and pitches a shutout, then, I don't know.
If they want to get back in this game, I think this is the inning that it needs to start happening.
Struck him out as his woes continue, as that's his third strikeout of the game. So the leadoff man set down now for Chase Utley. And this one runs a little too far in, ball two.
And this is where a guy who's been around a long time knows, hey, we're not going to make up the difference with just one swing. It's going to take base runners. So that's a good job of being really patient at the plate.
And he struck him out, and that's eight strikeouts thus far. Salvador Perez will stand in. He flew out his last time up. Swing and a liner toward right center. And this is into the alley and ought to be good for extra bases. And he's in there safely. He's got a double. Manny Machado will step in now as his guys look for a breakthrough here with a runner in scoring position.
Yeah, and it's been a long
Ooh,
time.
Ooh, that was ugly.
They haven't done anything with their opportunities so far. Maybe this will be the time that they finally crack the scoreboard.
And that misses ball four, so it's first and second now with two out. David Peralta will stand in, base on balls his last time. Now a swing as he shoots this one over to first. And the two-out threat will not come to pass as the inning is over. Brewers strand a couple. Lead looks insurmountable here. They're down 10-0. Back here at Miller Park in Milwaukee.
Oh, well, here comes a double switch.
Over, but the shouting as we check our game summary to see how we've gotten to where we are.
And look at that. Everybody's just quiet. There's not... There ain't a freaking peep in the building.
Growing any larger. Now the 1-1 home to Napoli.
Oh, my God.
Pitch in the dirt and falls behind now 1-2.
I guess it's probably because I'm not swinging at everything. That could possibly be it. Oh, my God.
Now some movement out in the Milwaukee bullpen. Both the lefty and a right-hander have begun to stretch it out. Oh, ties him up with a fastball inside. 1-2.
Yeah, and you know, this is a spot where you just have to make him bring the ball down.
It's very difficult to do anything positive when it's up that high.
Lays off 2-2 now. The pitch. And he gets under this one and in fact breaks his bat as this one's popped up. And this will not be caught. It's a foul ball. The 2-2 one more time. Took something off there, but this is hit well anyway out to deep center.
No. No.
And it's gone.
Are you kidding me?
Are you kidding me? They just continue to pour it on here.
Holy shit. Oh, and here comes the guy that's hit two homers already.
Well, this is the chance you take when you work up in the zone like this. I mean, this is right in his happy zone, and he jumps all over it and sends it right over the wall.
Standing in now, Yunel Escobar. Swing, and he takes this the other way to right. And that'll get by and on through towards the wall. Escobar rounds second. He's headed for third. And is in time as he's out at third as the good relay gets him.
I think I've well made up for last game, like in freaking.
In command. Here's the 1-1 pitch. Now a foul tip that's held onto with the plate, and the count moves to 1-2 now. Ball flying around the yard in this one, as you see so far there, and we'll have to leave it there as this is strike three, and that will retire the side.
Plus, I mean, pitching's been just lights out.
Entered into the ball game, he'll get his first plate appearance now here in inning number 7. Couldn't lay off that time, and it's 1-2.
Yeah, and that fastball's still got some life to it, even over 100 pitches.
And that's high for a ball. It's 2-2. Now the pitch. And he just manages to stay alive.
I'm not even going to get the bullpen up because AJ deserves to go all the way in this one.
Coming. And he's getting his money's worth up there now. It's full 3-2.
Oh, I think he'd be real happy with a leadoff walk. Something just to get things started against this guy.
And this will get over his outstretched glove. A great effort there, but it's a
It's not even that pitcher because they switched pitchers twice.
Per side here in the late going. And this one's low here, so the count swells to 3-1.
And a good job here of making him throw a lot of pitches. He probably doesn't have a whole lot left in the tank, so the more you make him work, the better your chances of getting a mistake.
Throw on the first by Longoria is right there for the first out. Adani Echevarria will stand in for the fourth time now, still looking for his first hit of the ball game.
And he's not the only one either.
Hold on now, that ball is down and could score a run. And the runner from second will stay put at third, so they're runners at the corners now with one.
There we go. Oh, need a double play.
He's been kept quiet out of the number three hole, hitless in his three at bats.
Not
so
that.
Far. And that'll just sneak past his outstretched arm, a base hit.
Well, for a while, it's getting dark. That's for sure.
Get on the board here in inning number 7. Now they've got to see if they can add on a few more and maybe make this game a little more interesting.
A couple of righties starting to loosen now in the bullpen. Now a throw over by Burnett, and he'll get back in standing. Now the payoff pitch home. Swinging a ball hit softly on the ground. Throw to third, and they get the force for the second out. But one's all they were ever going to get, and the inning will continue.
I heard while I was watching the developer stream for this game that if you go long enough, like if you go like 30 innings or something. Alright.
Brewers forced to settle for one. We'll look ahead to inning number 8 now.
Yeah, but I heard that you did like 30 innings or something. like that. Like, the sun will actually, like, rise. Which is hilarious, but,
Kenny Lofton will try again. 2-for-4 in the ballgame. Now here's a ground ball that will get by the mound and into center field for a leadoff single.
Just a great at-bat here to start the inning against a tough left-handed pitcher. You see him stay on this pitch all the way? He's aboard here with a leadoff single.
2-1. Goes the other way as this is lined to left. Dives, and he hangs on for the out. Wow!
That's nuts.
Ralph Kiner will step in. An RBI single this last time around. Now the 1-2. This is a hard hit ball back up the middle, and he's going to have his second hit tonight as it's into center field for a base hit. And he is in there.
Boy, you talk about a ball having eyes. First off, he's fortunate to get this one by the pitcher. It's not hit especially hard, but you'll see it get past second base where
neither can
track it down. And it'll make its way into center field.
Into the box, Evan Longoria. Now a ball hit back up the middle. On to Belt, and
the end of the inning.
The double play. That ends the inning. Salvador Perez will stand in to start out their half of the eighth with that starter still out there. He's definitely been a tough nut to crack.
No, he's been dominant all game long. And I think part of it is that he got himself a nice lead early on. That's allowed him to not really worry about
a nice lead early on, yeah. That's one way to say it.
Wade Davis will come in now working with a huge lead, so he'll just look to get some work in here. Heiner has to retreat a bit, but he gets there for route number one. Manny Machado will stand in, base on balls his last time. He goes the other way as this is hit in the air toward the gap in right center. And he will run this one down. A good read off the bat for the second out. Nick Swisher will get the call to pinch hit here as we'll see what he can do with two outs and the bases empty. And a fastball in the dirt that's taken for a ball. Bases are empty here with two men out. Taken the other way toward left center and fairly deep. Will reach out with one hand to make the catch on the move, and that ends the inning. Jerry's Familia will come on now in a mop-up role as he'll just try and keep this deficit from growing any larger. Now a ball lined toward center field, and that's a base hit, so the pressure's on to open up the inning.
Jesus. Crap.
Boy, that hit right there is just a thing of beauty. You talk about smoking one right back at the box. There isn't too many guys in the middle of that field that can catch a ball like that.
And a fastball there is inside as that one backed him up a bit.
He will definitely give you something to think about up there. There are no comfortable at-bats against this guy.
And this is hit well towards the hole. And a reach, but it's by him as he couldn't quite get to that ball. And that runner will go no further than second as there are two aboard now. Carlos Ruiz will stand in to try it again, already with one home run of the ball game, and on cue, here it was, back in the seventh inning, a solo shot that provided quite a spark for these guys. Here's the 1-1 pitch. Late on the fastball there as this one skied out toward right. Taking this one in is Moss, and there's your first out. And he'll indeed move up 90 feet, putting runners at the corners now with one away. Yunel Escobar will stride in again, and before he takes his cuts here, we take it back to inning number 6. This was his second home run of the ballgame as he'll stand in here looking for number 3. Runners leap from first and third. Here's the pitch. And look out as his bat shatters on impact. And he finds a way to focus on the baseball there as he has it for a big out number 2. Ichiro Suzuki. See what he can do off the bench as he'll bat with runners at the corners and two gone here. Runners on first and third, two away. Reaches down and hits this one on the ground to short. And an underhanded throw is in.
All right, let's finish this.
Pirates strand a couple, but they're on autopilot 11-1. Jonathan Papelbon is on now to try to close things down here in the ninth. Carlos Rivera will stand in now to begin their half of the ninth in a game that was decided long, long ago.
Yeah, this is mop-up time out there right now, but hey, these at-bats still count against your batting average, so you can't go up there and just mail it in. You've got to see this through right to the end of the game.
Now a swing and a sharp ground ball to third, and just past his outstretched glove into left, the base hit. Juan Ligares will step in, a ground-out victim his last time. Ball swung on and lifted in the air with some carry out towards left center. Oh, and he misses it! Not in time, and he's in there with a double. Adani Echevarria will dig in. He singled his last time around. Now a ball slapped hard the opposite way. That's in there. Base hit. And they're not going to get him. He's in there at the plate. Brandon Belt stand in to keep things going. And I don't know, Steve, is the comeback on?
Well, at the very least, I like that they're showing some character out there. You never want to go down without a fight. So they're going to make these final at-bats count.
Brandon Moss will stand in. He grounded into a fielder's choice of last time. Swing and a miss, and the count goes full, 3-2. He swings at the fastball here and lifts it into the air to shallow center. There to take it is Escobar, two away now. Chase Utley will bat now. He popped out in foul ground last time. And here's a ball hit in the air, and this is going to wind up a foul ball. Big pitch here, 1-2. And a fastball runs in a bit too close for comfort that time.
Yeah, not trying to hit him, I don't think. Sometimes you need...
And a sliding effort there, but he can't knock it down, and that'll float the runner from third.
That's all about picking up your teammate. The guy before him pops up and can't get the run home, so he's up there saying, hey, don't worry, I got him. Knocks in the two-out RBI.
And he gets this fastball over, back to 3-1 now.
Yeah, he needed that one to avoid loading the bases, but it's still a long road back from here.
Here's Papelbon now on 3-2. And he gets strike three called to end it here.
There you have it.
With that, this one is over.
And I think just about everybody wound up having a hand in this victory as they go on to win this one by 8 runs.
It's a total fail, a high five, but whatever. Well, let's check and see who our player of the game is.
This one pretty much over before it started as we give you a final look at the line score here in what turned 11, out to be a 3. Blowout victory. Wow. An entertaining game all in all, so if we have to choose one who stood out among all others, why not go with this man right here? He's our top player of the game.
Yeah, he connected on a couple of long home runs. Really put his guys on his back and carried them to the victory.
That puts our record at 2-2. So back even at 500 now after winning the last game, the final game against the Reds. So that will be about it for this video. Like, thank you guys for coming out. And well, see you in the next episode, guys.
Okay, let's send this, send the rest of the, series here and see what happens. Look at that, now we're at 4-2. Inside the show with Justin Allegri. Alright. I'll see you later, guys.
Baseball fans, a great weekend of baseball has...